Hello students, this is Murari Sharma. Let's cover the topic refraction of light. Last video mein humne refraction through glass slab cover kiya tha. Now let's cover with lens. Lens is basically structure which is formed by two solid spheres, two solid transparent spheres. This can either happen this way or that way. In this, one of these two solid sphere, its center of curvature is called C1 and center of other solid sphere is called C2. C1 and C2. Now if you join a line with these two points, then it will call principal axis and midpoint of these two is called pole. Right? So this is convex lens, which is bulged out from the middle, and this is concave lens, which is bulged out from the terminals. And midpoint of these two, C1 and P, is called F1. Midpoint of P and C2 is called F2. Focus 1, focus 2. Midpoint of these two is called focus 1, focus 2. Right? So what our lenses, these are two type of lenses: convex, bulge out from middle; concave, bulge out from the terminals. What does this lens do? It converges the light ray when it refracts through the surface. It converges. Converges means light ek dusre ke paas mein bend ho jati hai. Aur agar concave ki baat kare, after refraction light goes away, diverges from the lens. Okay, so this is also called convergent. Convergent lens, and this is also called divergent lens. Divergent lens, right? So now let us understand some basic terminology using convex lens. This is principal axis, a line which joins two center of curvatures. Okay, this is called principal axis. This is focus 1 and focus 2, and the distance between this point A and B, this distance is called aperture. Aperture, right? And beyond C, if there is a finite distance, then it is called beyond C. But if it is there infinite distance, which is not calculable, then it will be called infinite, right? And this point P is considered as origin, origin 0, 0, right? And you can draw, this is considered as x-axis, this is considered as y-axis. All the points which are on the right side are considered as positive, or their distance from point P are measured as positive, right? And next, upward positive, downward minus y axis negative, on the left side it is negative, right? So let us use these terminology and find out images for different position of object. Image formation due to convex lens. Okay, so number one case first, when object is at infinity. Simply, this is a convex lens, principal axis, center of curvature C1. This is point P, pole, right? And if we take an object at infinity, then light ray coming are shown as dotted lines and then straight. एंड डाइवर्जेंस या जो बेंडिंग होगी वो कहाँ से होगी, इस लाइन से विच पासिस थ्रू पी इंसिडेंट। एंड एक बात हमेशा याद रखिए, जो लाइट रे पैरेलल टू द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस आती है इट ऑलवेज पासिस थ्रू वन पॉइंट विच इज फोकस एफ टू, इन दिस कंडीशन इट इज एफ टू। नेक्स्ट अनदर लाइन पैरेलल टू द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस इट ऑल्सो पासिस थ्रू फोकस। सो इमेज विल फॉर्म एट पॉइंट एफ टू विच इज वेरी स्मॉल एंड रियल। सो इमेज इट इज रियल एंड इन्वर्टेड, साइज हाईली डिमिनिश्ड। ओके, हाईली डिमिनिश्ड एंड कैन बी प्लॉटेड ऑन द स्क्रीन, रियल इमेज कैन बी प्लॉटेड ऑन द स्क्रीन। केस सेकेंड, केस सेकेंड व्हेन ऑब्जेक्ट इज बियॉन्ड सी, इज बियॉन्ड सी वन, सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर वन, राइट। दिस इज लेंस, कॉन्वेक्स लेंस, प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, दिस पॉइंट इज सी वन। Now this time object is beyond C1 and it is at finite distance, right? Light coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through F2, focus 2. And now you have to understand one more thing, that this there is a point C2, center of curvature of second part of the lens. Now this time when object is beyond C1, one light which passes through this point P pole and it crosses it here, you can draw it here C2 and it meets here, means when object is beyond C1 then image forms between F2 and C2 which is inverted. If you can see it is inverted, that is very simple to observe that it is a real image which can be plotted on the screen. So image real and inverted, size of image you can see it is smaller, right? So this is second case. Let's come to the case number 3. When object is at C1, this is lens, principal axis, C1, F1, object is at C1, light coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through F2, and light going through this point P pole will pass undeviated, and this is where it will meet C2. This time both these are equal, C1 and C2, object at C1, image will form at C2. Image is equal size, image is real and inverted, size ki baat karein, equal size, okay. So this is third case in which object is placed at C1, image forms at C2 which is equal in size and inverted. Case fourth, k is fourth. When object is between C1 and F1, between C1 and F1, right? So this is lens. Pole, this point is pole P. This is C1, this is F1. Object is here. Then light coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through a point, focus F2, and you have to show these arrows, which are very essential, right? So light ray, we need at least two light rays to show formation of an image. These two light rays are meeting after C2 and image is larger, so but even then it is inverted, so real image in this case also, image is real and inverted. Size of the image, you can say size is larger than object, larger than object. And this, let's come to fifth case. Case fifth, when object is at focus 1, convex lens C1 F1. This is object, point P. Light coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through F2, and light passing through this point P will go undeviated, means both these two light rays after refraction will be parallel to each other. So you can understand these parallel lines will meet somewhere, means a point which is at infinity, they will meet at infinity. So image real and inverted, size very very large, size will be very very large, right? So this is the fifth case. In these all five cases, you have seen that image formed is real and inverted. Now let's come to last sixth case, in which it will be different and very useful. You can see case sixth is very important. When object is between C1 and F1, right? This is convex lens C1 F1 and object is here. Light coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through F2, and light going this through pole which goes undeviated, and you can see these two light rays are diverted, they will never meet ahead, so we produce them backwards and they will meet here before C1 on the same side but erect, not inverted. So image this time is virtual and erect. You can see the size larger than object. So this is the sixth case, which is also used in microscope, in which we see the object enlarged. Okay, this is the sixth case which is used, which is asked in exams also. So you can understand this in the same direction, image is formed and larger than the object, it is virtual. Virtual means isko hum screen ke upar plot nahi kar sakte. Okay, so this was lens and image formation with convex lens. Now let's see lens formula and magnification through lens. image formed by lens. Lens formula and magnification. Lens formula and magnification. Simply consider this lens, convex lens, and this point is called P, pole C1, center of curvature of this imaginary solid sphere. This distance from P to C1 is called R1, radius of curvature, and this point C2, this distance is called radius of curvature R2, right? And midpoint of this is called F1. Midpoint of these two is called F2, and distance from P to F1 is called focal length 1. Distance from P to F2 is called focal length 2, right? Okay, and you have to understand, if object is on the left side, which is always true, we always consider object on the left side, right? And the distance from P to object is called U, and if image forms this side, right side of the lens, then the distance is considered as V. Always, generally it happens, image forms right side, which distance of the image is considered as V, and this is F1. So lens formula aapko yaad rakhna hai ye, 1 upon F is equals to 1 upon V minus 1 upon U. बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है, मिरर के अंदर जो फॉर्मूला था उसमें आया था प्लस, लेंस फॉर्मूला में आता है माइनस, 1 अपॉन एफ इज इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन वी माइनस 1 अपॉन यू. एंड मैग्निफिकेशन स्मॉल एम इज इक्वल्स टू एच डैश अपॉन एच, हाइट ऑफ इमेज अपॉन हाइट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, और दिस टाइम प्लस वी अपॉन यू. दिस इज मैग्निफिकेशन. मैंने आपको मिरर में बताया होगा मैग्निफिकेशन क्या होता है. कोई भी लेंस या मिरर किसी ऑब्जेक्ट की इमेज को कितना बड़ा या छोटा करके दिखा सकता है. दैट कैपेसिटी इज कॉल्ड मैग्निफिकेशन. दैट इज कॉल्ड मैग्निफिकेशन, द डिग्री ऑफ डाइवर्जेंस और कन्वर्जेंस, राइट? सो हाइट ऑफ इमेज अपॉन हाइट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, और डिस्टेंस ऑफ इमेज फ्रॉम द पोल अपॉन डिस्टेंस ऑफ द इमेज, सॉरी डिस्टेंस ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम द पोल. सो इस रेशियो को क्या कहते हैं? मैग्निफिकेशन. क्लियर? और मैग्निफिकेशन अगर आपके पास नेगेटिव आ रहा है इट शोज रियल इमेज, और पॉजिटिव आ रहा है इट शोज वर्चुअल इमेज. सो दिस वॉज रिफ्रैक्शन. सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो विथ न्यू टॉपिक. थैंक यू.